They say that falling in love is wonderful. It's wonderful. So they say. And with a moon up above, it's wonderful. It's wonderful. So they tell me.
I remember it was 8th grade when I got my first girlfriend. So we did the whole middle school thing where like we talked with each other and then we texted, and then one day I was like, "Do you want to be my girlfriend?" And she was like, "Yes." And I was just pretty jazzed about that. And I think we dated for 1 week, and then she texted me and she's like, "I can't do this." And I was like, "What do you mean? We're like not even doing anything. We're just like sitting with each other more than we sit with other people." And she's like, "No, I can't do this." And so she broke up with me because I guess the stress was too much of the middle school dating lifestyle. Then a week later, she started dating my best friend. And that was a blow to morale, to say the least. And it sounds dumb now, but at the time, I just remember feeling crushed, and like only the way that a middle schooler in love can feel crushed. And of course, you know, they dated for like an entire year. So in my junior year of high school, there was a girl, and we went on a couple of dates. I asked her to prom. Things were going pretty well. And then we left for spring break, and she went on a mission trip. And then she came back, and she told me that something had happened on the trip, religiously, to where she knew that we could not be together anymore. You know, I was hurt, but it wasn't the worst thing in the world. And a couple weeks go by, and prom gets nearer. And she's like, "Okay, when are you gonna pick me up for prom?" And I was like, "Hold on, hold the phone here. We broke up like 2 weeks ago, and you think we're still going to prom?" And she was like, "Well, yeah, you asked me." And meanwhile, I'm like, "What? Like, no, like we broke up." But I was like, "Okay, whatever." And so the day before prom, I went and got a tux, and I went to prom. Kind of a miserable time. Tried to hang out with her as little as possible. And I guess I just find it funny because nowadays I can look back on that. I'm like, "Man, that was a really dumb situation on both of our sides." But at the time, I just remember feeling kind of embarrassed and kind of stupid about the whole thing. So senior year of high school, I had this friend for the entirety of high school, and we were always close, but senior year we got really close, and gosh, I think we talked on the phone every night for almost the entire year. And in that way, we both kind of developed feelings for each other. But she had a boyfriend, I should say. She had a boyfriend that she'd had since freshman year. So they'd been dating for 3.5 years. But at the end of senior year, she broke up with him to get with me. At the time, I was pretty jazzed about that. So we graduate, and my family's getting ready to move up to Nova, or Northern Virginia. And they need to go look at houses. And so I say, "Leave me behind. because I want to go out with this girl who I've had a crush on for a while. And so, surprisingly, they say yes. And for the next week, this girl came over to my house and spent the night at the house. At the end of that week, she expressed some feelings that I couldn't reciprocate. Just because, you know, we were leaving for college and I was moving and we were going to different colleges. And so she left and I never saw her again. And we haven't talked since. It was someone really close to me who was a really good friend of mine. And I lost that person. And I think it always sucks when you lose a friend, but to do it in such a knuckleheaded way of like putting, you know, like physical feelings ahead of that is something that I still feel bad about even today. Yeah.